Click the bell icon to get latest videos from Ikeda.
Hello friends, today we will see law of radioactive disintegration. We know radioactive elements spontaneously emit radiation and it converts into the new element. So let us see what is the law of radioactive disintegration. Now let us consider n is the number of particle present in the element. Now we'll consider n naught, that is number of particle disintegrate in time in a small time dt. Now here we know the number of particle disintegrate is directly proportional to the total number of particle present at that instant. Hence, we can write rate of decay is directly proportional to the number of atom present at time t. Hence, we will write here rate of decay, that is dn by dt, is directly proportional to the number of atom present at that instant t. So we'll write here directly proportional to n. But here we have to take a negative sign. Here negative sign indicates rate of disintegration increases, the number of atom decreases. Hence we have equation, that is minus dn by dt is directly proportional to n. Now here we have to remove proportionality constant, so we'll write here minus dn by dt is equal to lambda n. Now here lambda is proportionality constant, or we can say it is disintegration constant or decay constant. Hence, here we have equation, that is dn by dt is equal to lambda n. Let us say this is equation number 1. Now, we will rearrange this equation. Dn by dt is equal to minus lambda n. Let us integrate this equation both the sides. Hence, here we have dn by n is equal to minus lambda dt. We can add this step here, that is dn by n is equal to minus lambda dt. So, this is equation number 2. So, integrating both the sides, equation. Now, here we will integrate with number of particle present at time t0 to number of total number of particle presents. So, here we will write n0 is number of particles present initially. So, initially means here time t0. And let us integrate this side by time, that is initial time t naught to time t at any instant t. Hence we have equation, that is so here we will solve this equation. We will have log of n with limits n naught to n. Lambda is a constant and the integration of dt is t. And here limits are t naught to t. So, we'll write here log n minus log n naught, which is equal to minus lambda. Again here we have t minus t naught. Here we can write log n upon n naught is equal to minus lambda t. Here initial time t naught is initial time. And we are considering initial time t naught is 0. Hence, this will become 0. So, here we have only minus lambda t. Now, if you want to remove log, then we have to write here exponential function. So, this will become n upon n naught is equal to e raised to minus lambda t. Hence, this equation can be written as n is equal to n naught e raised to minus lambda t. Now, we will see this equation graphically. Let us consider this is time along x-axis and here we have number of unchanged particle. That is n. Hence, here we have an exponential graph. So, initially, when time is 0, then at that time, we have total number of particle present, that is n. But as time increases, the number of particle decreases in this way. So, we can say at a small time dt, number of particle present is dn. So, we can say at time, small time dt, number of particle disintegrate, that is dn. So, this is the equation for decay. Let us see what is the concept of half-life period. Now, it is defined as the time in which half of the radioactive substance disintegrate. We know initially we are considering substance that is n, that is total number of particle present in the radioactive element n in time t. But half period means half of the substance disintegrate, means n becoming n by 2. So, if we say initial number of particle at time t0 is n naught. So, we can say at time t half, the total number of particle disintegrate, that is a half. So, n becoming n naught. Now, we know the equation. That is the equation of radioactive decay. N is equal to n naught exponential of minus lambda t. Let us find out what is the equation for half-life period. The concept of half-life period is the substance is disintegrating into the half amount in given time. So, that time will be half time. So, here we will consider the amount of substance disintegrated to its half amount. So, n by 2, this is n. And e raised to minus lambda. Now, here we are considering half of the substance. So, this t will become now t half. This is n naught. So, this n naught will get cancelled here. So, here we have half e raised to minus lambda t half. This minus sign we can remove by writing half is equal to 1 upon e raised to lambda t half. So, from this equation, we can write 2 is equal to e raised to lambda t half. Let us take log of both the sides. So, this will become log of 2 is equal to, here we'll take lambda t half. Hence, t half, that is half-life period, can be written as log of 2 upon lambda. We know what is the value of log of 2, that is 0.693 upon lambda. So, this is the equation for half-life period. Now, half-life period for radium is, we can take one example, that is, half-life period for radium is 1620 years. This is the half-life period for the radium. We know minus dN by dt is equal to lambda n. So, here we can write down lambda is equal to minus dN by dt upon n. Hence, we can define lambda Hence, we can define decay constant lambda is the ratio of amount of substance disintegrated in unit time, means dN by dt, to the total amount of substance present, means total amount of substance is N. So, in this way, we can define decay constant. Now, we know here N is equal to N naught e raised to minus lambda t. Now, here the value of t, that is half-life period if we are considering, then we say t half is equal to, just now we have calculated, that is 0.693 upon lambda, that is half-life period. We say t is equal to 1 upon lambda, that is full life period. So, instead of t, we will write here 1 upon lambda. Hence, our equation is n is equal to n naught e raised to minus lambda upon 1 upon lambda. So, this lambda will get cancelled. Here we have only e, that is e raised to minus 1. So, here we can write n is equal to n naught upon e. So, we know value of e, that is 2.718. Hence, we can write n is equal to 0.37 n naught. Hence, decay constant can be again defined as the reciprocal of that time duration in which the number of atoms of radioactive substance falls to 37% of its original value. So, in this way, we can understand the concept of radioactive disintegration. Thanks for watching this video. Stay tuned with IKEDA and please subscribe IKEDA. Thank you.